Good evening. In our last session, we have seen the different operators available in C program. We just started the operators point. We have seen all the arithmetic operators in C programming language. Then we have seen increment operator, decrement operator, then prefix and postfix operator in assignment statements. The next operators in C programming language are logical operators. Logical operators are basically used to combine more than one condition in a program. So we have three different logical operators in a C programming language, that is logical AND. It is written as double ampersand symbol. Then logical OR, we represent logical OR by this symbol. Then we have third logical operator, that is logical NOT, exclamation, it is represented by exclamation mark like this. Now, we will see the example using the logical operators. Consider a code given to you like this. Integer x equal to 5, y equal to 7, z equal to 3. And the conditions are written here. Some examples of conditions are written. If x is less than or equal to y, the output of any logical operator is always true or false. If the condition is true, the result of the logical operator is true. Otherwise, the result is false. Now check the first example given here and we will see what is the output of this expression, logical operator, that is if x less than or equal to y. If you put the values of x and y here into this expression condition, that is x is 5 and y is 7, and the result of this condition becomes true because 5 is less than 7. Second example is if x is greater than or equal to z. We are checking whether x is greater than or equal to z. Here x is 5 and z is 3, and the condition is again true because 5 is greater than 3. Third example is if x is less than or equal to y, and check the second condition, the same condition, that is x is greater than or equal to z. The result of the first condition is true as well as second condition is true, and the combined result is true because in case of AND operator, logical operator, if both the conditions are true, the result is true. If any one of the conditions becomes false, the final result is false. Check the next example. Here, we are checking whether x is less than or equal to y and x is less than or equal to z also. Here, the output of the first condition is true and the second condition is false. It means, in this AND operator operation, first is true and second is false, the final result is false. Now, we will see the logical OR operator, use of logical OR operator. We are checking whether x is less than or equal to y and x is greater than or equal to z. Here, the condition, first condition is true as well as second condition is true. Both the conditions are true. In logical OR operator, if both the conditions are true, the result is true. Or either of the condition is true, again the result is true in OR operation. The result is false only when both the conditions result is false. Check the last example. Here you are checking if x is greater than y or x is less than z. This condition result is false because 5 is not greater than 7. X is less than or equal to z, 5 is not less than 3 also. It means the result of this condition is also false. The condition of both the results is false. In case of OR operation, if both the conditions are false, final result is also false. So this ends the logical operators. Now we have another operator called as shorthand assignment operator in C program. And it is represented like this. Operator operand 1, the operator that is used for assignment operator, shorthand assignment operator, equal to symbol and operand 2. The line A equal to A plus B can also be written like this with the help of shorthand assignment operator. A plus equal to B is equivalence to the line in C program, that is A equal to A plus B. A minus equal to B is similar to the line A equal to A minus B. Both the outputs are same. The result of both these expressions are same. So we can represent any expression like this in terms of shorthand assignment operator like this. A equal to a into b can be written as a into equal to b by using shortcut assignment operator. We also have relation operators in C. Basically, we use relation operator for comparing one side to another side. Whether LHS is greater than or less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to check both the sides. Which side is larger or which side is small. We can use relation operator for it, and the output of relation operator is also in terms of true or false. Just check in this example, above example, here we are checking x is greater than or equal to y. We are relating x with y. We are checking whether x is greater than y or not. This can be termed as a relation operator. Okay. So in this case, x is 5 and y is 7 and x is not greater than y. The result of this relation operator is false. So relational operators can be greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, double equal to, that is equal to, equality sign, equality operator, and not equal to. So these are all the relational operators that we have in C programming language. We are going to use all these operators in a C program. Okay. Now the next topic is input output statements in a C programming language. So what are different input and output statements in C programming language? We have two statements, that is scanf and printf, considered as input and output statement respectively. Scanf is used for reading the input from the user, whereas printf is used for displaying the output on the screen. Now we'll see the syntax of the printf statement. If I want to print any message on the screen, I am going to use printf statement for it in the C program. The syntax of printf statement is like this: printf in bracket in double quotes. You can write any message that you want to print on the screen in double quotations. Okay. If you want to print the value of any variable, you have to use the second syntax, that is printf in double quotes, mention all the format specifiers. If you want to declare a character variable value, you have to use the format specifier, that is %c. For integer variable, use %d. For float, use %f. And for double variable, use %lf. Okay. And mention all the variable names. After closing this double quotation, give comma, mention variable name 1, comma, variable name 2, comma, and so on. Close the bracket and give semicolon. To display the variable values, we use this second syntax. For displaying the message, we use first syntax. Okay. Examples are given here. Okay. The first example is just to print a message, welcome to the world of C. I can print that message with the help of this printf line in any C program. Printf in double quotes, welcome to the world of C. Close the double quote here, give semicolon at the last of this line to terminate that line. So this printf line will going to print the message welcome to the world of C on the screen. Second example, we have two variables of integer type, a equal to 5 comma b equal to 6, and I wanted to print the values of variable a and b on the screen. So we use this printf line. Here we are mentioning in double quotes a equal to is the message, whereas percentage is the format specifier for the first variable, that is integer variable. For b equal to percentage d, again it means b is also an integer variable. Close this double quote, give semicolon, and mention the names of the variable where the values are stored, a comma b. If you write a line, printf line, in any program of C, you will find the message on the screen, that is a equal to 5 and b equal to 6. Now we will see the another syntax that we are using for reading the values of variable in the C program. We use scanf statement to read the values from the user. Basically, scanf is used to read values of variables from users at runtime. The syntax that we use for reading is, suppose there are two variables, integer a comma b. We will first prompt a message to the user on the screen about entering the values of a and b, like enter the values of a and b. After this colon mark, enter the values of a and b, correct? So this is the message that we are going prompting to the user on the screen before reading the values of A and B. Use the scanf statement to read the values. The syntax for scanf is, in double quote, we have to mention all the format specifier. So how many values we are reading in this example? We are reading two values. So we need two percentage D. First percentage D for variable A, second percentage D for variable B, value of variable B. Close this double quotation, give comma, and write ampersand A, comma, ampersand B, and close this statement here by semicolon. Now, what is the meaning of ampersand A and ampersand B? It means that read the value of the first variable here and store it at the address of variable A. Read the second value here and store it at the address of variable B. So, ampersand is the symbol basically used in C programming language to indicate the address of the variable. So, this scanf statement will going to read the value of the variable and store it at the respective addresses of variables A and B. Now, the next topic is different comment statements available in C. How to comment any line in C program? Now, what are comment statements in C? Comment statements are used in programs to explain the logic, the author detail, etc. in the C program. There are two types of comments in C programming language, that is called as single line comment and multi line comment. Single line comments are basically written like this in the C program. Before any code, if you put double forward slash, that line is considered as a single line comment. All the comments are ignored by the compiler. The next type of comment is multi-line comment, and it is represented by the symbol forward slash asterisk, then number of lines of codes, then close with the symbol asterisk and forward slash like this. So these dotted lines indicate that number of lines of codes can be there, right, inside the starting and ending point of the multi-line comment. So this way we represent any large code by multi-line comment. So all the lines which are represented in the starting and end point of the multi-line comment are ignored by the compiler. So we use this type of comments in C program. Now the next topic is escape sequences in C programming language, basically used to format our output data display. We use escape sequences basically to format our output data display. Many times we use in C program slash n, slash t. What is slash n? Slash n is the line feed or new line. If you use this slash n in a code, it will print the output on the next line. Slash t is equivalent to the tab button, tab spaces available on the keyboard. Slash b is nothing but backspace. So we can represent those characters with the help of these escape sequences. So this ends your introduction to the C programming language. In our next session, we are going to study some of the programs in C program. We are going to write the programs in C. So this ends your introduction to the programming in C. If you have any doubts, you can ask me into the chat room, or you can raise your hand by clicking on the hand raise button here. Any doubts?